Parabolic Sapi SAR. Parabolic Sapi SAR was developed by J. Wells Wilder Jr. and helps in determining the entry and exit points. SA stands for stop and reverse. SA computes stop loss levels using previous day's data. Some of the concepts in PSAR computation are: extreme price, this is the highest price recorded to date during a long trade or the lowest price recorded to date during a short trade. Acceleration factor, the acceleration factor is a rate at which the SA converges with the price. Typically, the minimum acceleration factor is kept at 2% for every new level reached in the existing trend up to a maximum of 20%. When to use? 1. The parabolic system is similar to a moving average, but it has the added advantage of a trailing stop reversal indicator that moves in the direction of the price trend. The SA points below the price point indicate a long position while the SA point above the price point indicates a short position. When the market penetrates this stop and reverse point, the current position should be liquidated and the opposite position should be taken. If long, liquidate the long position and establish a short position. If short, liquidate the short position and establish a long position. 2. When a trend begins, the SA points move in small increments and maintain their furthest difference from the price. This allows the trend to develop and prevents positions from being closed out in the event of an early adverse price movement. When the trend becomes established and gains momentum, the gap between SAs widens and distance from the price narrows. This is due to the acceleration factor of in the system. Volume-weighted moving average, VWMA. As stated in its name, the volume-weighted moving average, VWMA, is similar to the simple moving average, however, the VWMA places more emphasis on the volume recorded for each period. Therefore, if you place a 20-period simple moving average, SMA, on your chart and at the same time, a 20-period volume-weighted moving average, you will see that they pretty much follow the same trajectory. However, on further review, you will notice the averages do not mirror each other exactly. An N-day volume-weighted moving average, VWMA, is the average of the past N days' closing prices, each weighted in proportion to the volume on that day. Calculations. When to use. This indicator gives buy and sell signals upon crossovers with price or another MA. Thus a buy signal is generated when a fast-moving volume-weighted moving average crosses above a slow-moving simple moving average and a sell signal is generated when it crosses below the slow-moving simple moving average. Average Directional Movement Index ADX. ADX indicator used in technical analysis is an objective value for the strength of the trend. ADX is non-directional so it quantifies a trend's strength regardless of whether it is up or down. Calculations. Plus DM equals today's high yesterday's high when price moves upward. DM equals yesterday's low today's low when price moves downward. Calculate the true range for the day. True range is the largest of today's high today's low today's high yesterday's close and yesterday's close today's low. Plus DM 14 equals PREV plus DM asterisk 13 plus current plus DM 14 14 German marks equals PREV DM asterisk 13 plus current DM 14 TR 14 equals PREV TR asterisk 13 plus current TR 14. Next, calculate the directional indicators plus D 14 equals plus DM 14 divided by TR 14 DI 14 equals 14 German marks divided by TR 14. Then, calculate the components of the average directional movement index ADX, calculate the D difference. Record the difference between plus D 14 and DI 14 as a positive number. Calculate the directional index DX. DX equals the difference divided by the sum of plus D 14 and DI 14 ADX equals PREV DX asterisk 13 plus current DX 14. When to use. The ADX oscillator fluctuates between 0 and 100. Even though the scale is from 0 to 100, readings above 60 are relatively rare. Low readings, below 20, indicate a weak trend and high readings, above 40, indicate a strong trend. The indicator does not grade the trend as bullish or bearish but merely assesses the strength of the current trend. A reading above 40 indicate a strong downtrend as well as a strong uptrend. ADX can also be used to identify potential changes in a market from trending to non-trending. When ADX begins to rise from below 20 and moves above 20, it is a sign that the trading range is ending and a trend is developing.